wing, looking back outside to Poo-Poo Pal, that now to DeMarco right, left wing, looking down low. They run Philippe through, and that good D on him. They cut him back door, had a cutter backside. Now back over DeMarco right from the right side. DeMarco went to shoot, blocked away from him. Picked up here by Davis in the corner. Davis kicks it to Jones, and Jones will bring it on the attack. Boy, they play a good tough D. Jones outside. They're going to let him shoot that one off the rim. Won't go. Rebounded by Jones. Jones right. He caught the ball, though, and he should have had a
get away with a walk.
He got by with a travel. Jones knows it. He's grinning. He says, yes, it did. And he got it to Rogers, and Rogers drew the foul. He did get by with a travel. That was called on Chris Buesen. 17 fouls on Newton, and Carlos Rogers is going to go on the line. He has 2 field goals and 3 free throws, 3 out of 5 at the free throw line. 4:07 to play, first half. Carlos Rogers shot it, and Carlos Rogers missed it.
He's the reigning Ohio Valley Conference Player of the Year and the preseason choice for the same honor.
He's 3 of 6 at the free throw line, shooting 65% at the free throw line on the year. This one's up, back of the rim, won't go. Battle far, picked up here by Pooh. They battle for the basketball. Pooh keeps it alive, and they said Pooh stepped out of bounds.
Pooh claiming he was pushed there. Pooh claiming he was pushed there, and I know he was.
That's Carlos Rogers is not doing very good at the free throw line. Gurnell will inbound the basketball from side back foot.
Rogers shoots 65% for the season from the charity stripe, 121 of 186.
Coach Kyle Luther over there, very reflective, and follow some instructions out.
When you see Kyle Luther come off with that jacket, you know he means business over there. He came off with that very early in this basketball game.
You know that action is hot and heavy. Bob Ward is over there talking to the official about they get squared away, I guess. Gurnell will inbound the basketball to Neil Jones, and Neil will bring it on the attack. 4:13 to play in the first half of play. With the basketball is Horton out to have the key. He's being pressured by Philippe Phillips over to Neil Jones' right side. Neil looking in to Rogers. Rogers down low with the shoot, blocked away, got it back, slapped out of his hands, and goes out of bounds off his fingertips. And Rogers is upset over the call.
He was triple-teamed down low, got the ball inside about 2 foot from the bucket. May have been too close to the bucket that time. On the second chance, he was stripped away. The ball went off him and back to the face.
Chris Houston was trying to come through a two-man trap and trying to split it, and they got him tied up, and they kicked the ball, so we'll get another 30 seconds. Buesen inbounds quickly to Philippe Phillips, down the floor to DeMarco Wright. They hurry bound down behind him, picks up the dribble, gives it to Buesen, back outside to Philippe Phillips, puts up a three, knocked it home. Philippe got it.
Got to have that from Philippe.
Yes, sir. 23, 33 paces down by 10. Neil Jones will bring it down. Neil will come across the timeline with it. Comes down the floor, works down the right side. Neil drives to drive the baseline. Backs out, he couldn't go in the tall trees. Over to Tim Horton out front. Tim has the key holding. Gonna work right, looks low to Rogers and posting him up and holding him down there. He's posting up Buesen. There was a traveling call and a turnover, Tennessee State.
He drug the pivot foot right there in front of our desk.
And right in front of that official. He was eyeballing that thing pretty closely. So, you know, they're human too, just like they had in the women's game, huh? Sometimes you wonder with the athleticism that they have as Philippe Phillips will bring it across the timeline. Now the outside to DeMarco Wright. Now gives left wing to Poupal down deep left baseline corner to Chris Buesen. Back out front to Sidney Benton. Now to the key. Gurnell right on him. Out to Philippe. Puts one in the NBA range and he got it.
He's getting a feeling.
He may get in the zone, hopefully. Neil Jones brings it left side. Jones looks inside. He gets down to Rogers and triple team him. The ball slapped away and goes out of bounds. And touch plays, they say, by the Pacers. Oh, they triple teamed him that time. Rogers, we're talking about the big fella down in the paint.
Well, Philippe Phillips can step up and make that three-pointer on a consistent basis, Bill. Certainly that takes the pressure off Pooh Powell, Carlos Knox, and DeMarco Wright. And the Pacers aren't so one-dimensional offensively. Big, big factor for UTM.
Curtis Davis in the ballgame, replacing Gurnell. Back to Neil Jones up high. And Jones working out to the key. Now flips it left side to Horton. Horton on the left wing being pushed. Tries to drive baseline. He's shut off. Can't go. He walks with the ball. Tim drugged the pivot foot. I didn't get a foul. No, a charging foul on Tim Horton.
Second straight possession. Tim Horton turned it over.
Well, he was shoving a guy off along the baseline. And I thought for a while he may have traveled, but it. Philippe Phillips with the ball. He gets it down to Sidney Benton, and Benton will bring it across the timeline. Down left corner to DeMarco Wright. Back out to Philippe Phillips, puts up a three.
Good!
He's hot. When you're hot, when you're hot, you're hot. When you're not, you're not. Right now he's hot. Lead the hot hand, 33-29, faces 12 by 4. And the crowd gets into it. Neil Jones, baseline right side. Neil Jones kicks it back inside to Rogers. And a foul has been called on Sidney Benton. And they were just battling for the basketball and just another foul. Was it Sidney or was it Pooh?
I think it was Pooh.
Pooh. Because I didn't touch him, Mr. Bell.
I tell you who is touching something, and that's Philippe Phillips. He's really stroking it right now. Those last two, Bill, were for NBA. Those were 25-footers.
I hope some of the NBA guys are here, scouts here tonight, see that, you know.
They may make a note or two about number 22 of UT
right.
Martin.
Right, they come to see Carlos, and maybe, you know, sometimes that happens.
That's exactly right.
Carlos Rogers on the line. He's been there all night, shot it and got it. Shooting 65%, but he hasn't done that tonight. And hope he doesn't get in a flow. They can hear voices all over this place. Good crowd on this snowy cold night.
Shot it, got it.
And two of two there. 35-29, 6-point lead here by Tennessee State. Carlos Knox moves it on the attack. Out to Philippe Phillips, has the key working right side. Philippe on the right wing looking, needs some help. Gets to Sidney Benton out front. Benton gives it back over to Philippe Phillips outside. And there was a foul called on, what was that?
Illegal
screen, I think, maybe on Sidney Benton. Sidney is a marked man right now. He has his second foul. And as Ryan Burge will get in for Sidney, he picked up two. Don't want him to get three right now. It's 2:03 to play first half. And we still got some time to go in this one. This way of going is to be anybody's ballgame. Nobody's really showed a dominance here yet.
In the first 18 minutes, Bill, UT Martin has made 7 3-point field goals and only 3 from 2-point range.
As Tim Horton missed the first of the 1-1. And on the rebound, fighting part went off the fingertips of Chris Houston, so it will be inbounded here by Tim Horton on the Tennessee State basket. Horton will inbound. Horton gives it back outside to Neil Jones, and Jones with it works out to the deep. Jones working left to Davis outside, puts up a long three, and Davis did that to us up in Nashville. As his first three, 38-29, Pacers trailed by 9. Philippe Phillips over to Chris Houston. Hands it to DeMarco Wright. DeMarco Wright, Carlos Knox, right side down low in the paint. Hook shot there by Houston, missing. Rebounded Horton, picked up here, giving it to Jones. Jones on the run. He'll bring it down, stops outside. Looks right side to Horton, up to Rogers, took the shot, and Rugg got the good roll and popped in there for two. That's one of the three field goals to come for Carlos this first half. And he's been on the free throw line all night. Philippe Phillips with the ball, working outside, man-to-man pressure by Tennessee State. Gives it to DeMarco Wright, stop for the 10-footer, good by DeMarco. DeMarco Wright did a good job, going off that high pick. Phillips hit him for the easy 12-footer. 40-31, faces down by 9, 108 to play in the first half. Don't forget at halftime, we'll be talking to Coach John McGill. We're going to have some kind of ceremony here at halftime. Davis with another long three, he's missing that one. Rebounded Carlos Knox, the foul call.
11 had a hold of Carlos Knox there behind as Neil Jones. That would cost him 15 yards on Saturday afternoon.
That's a holding right there, sure enough. He wasn't going to let him go anywhere. He had grabbed that jersey just how long ago he left. He was going to sit down for a while. And coming back in the ballgame, that's good to get. We will get a 1+1 here, won't we?
Yes.
Carlos Knox on the line. Carlos has 5 points.
He's an 80% free throw shooter.
He's a 6'2 freshman of Dayton, Ohio, a true freshman. He hit that one. Thanks, we needed that 8-point difference here now in the first half. 58 seconds inside of a minute. As Carlos hits another free throw. Carlos shot it, and Carlos got it. 2-2 of the line. 40-33, 7-point lead. With the ball now on the attack as Greg Watkins, he'll bring it down. Greg comes across the sideline, works the right side. They run Horton inside to Big Rogers. They double team him outside to Watkins. Watkins in the corner to Davis. Davis rolling out front. He'll put up that three from way out there. Starting him is Sidney Benton, left side to Rico Beasley. Beasley back out to Davis. Davis now flips to Horton. Horton in there. Horton is going to drive. Horton is going to take baseline. Going to put it up. It's missing. Battle far underneath. Picked up here by Philippe Phillips. He scoops up the garbage. And he gets it off here to Carlos Knox. 20 seconds on the clock. Faces bounce fast. Feed down to DeMarco Wright. Backing out. Spinning. on the wing, comes right back on the attack, takes it under, and he had the ball slapped away and slapped out of bounds. It's going to be Pacer basketball. It was blocked away by Carlos Rogers.
He was showing no fear taking the ball inside of the big fella. That's three blocks for Rogers.
Said, I'll take it to you, big man. You may be NBA first round, but you don't intimidate me. Marco Wright will inbound ball. I tell you, a team coach like Cal Lizard don't get intimidated.
You're exactly right.
Ball was kicked as he inbounded it. If you get intimidated, you sit over there and hold his hand.
Real close.
Yeah, right. Just scores the game. As DeMarco will inbound the ball, looking inside to Dick. Benton gives it a knock. Knock takes it in the corner, being pressured. Spin comes out of there. Carlos with it, popped up a 15-footer. Good! By Carlos Fox. 35 paces down to 5. Driving. Watkins lays it up. Won't go. Tipped up and tipped in. And it's going to be good. As Carlos Rogers got the tip in as the buzzer went off. Son of a gun. How about them apples? 40. 35. And Coach Bob Ward is over discussing as he wants to say, wave it off, wave it off. But he didn't wave it off, I don't think. And the faces are still out there. We'll stay right here for just a moment. Okay. We're going to take a two-minute break. We'll be back here in 2 minutes on the Pacers Sports Network.
WLJT TV Channel 11, Lexington Martin, Public Television.
Play of this ball game after Rico Beasley, right side to Damon Page, puts up a three-pointer off the back of the rim, bounces up over the backboard, and it's going to go out of bounds. Going to be Pacer basketball. We're down by 7. Pacers are down by 7. We're within 10. We're in the second half of play. Boo Powell will walk it down. He'll come across the timeline with it. Works left to DeMarco right. DeMarco working left wing, holding out front. There you see.
Did he travel? Is that what he called?
That was a call out there. And that was the kind of mistake that'll drive a coaching staff mad. That's just an unforced turnover, Bill. There was no pressure on DeMarco Wright. He just drove a pivot foot there and turned the ball over.
With the ball, Horton will take it on the attack, working right side, picked up by Malik Phillips, sends it back over to Carlos Rogers out to Tim Horton. He puts up a three, it's off the rim, won't fall. Rebound to Johnson. Two guys hit the deck. Pooh Powell goes down, and so does 24 Damon Page goes down. Pooh Powell drew the foul.
In third.
Huh? That's his third one, and he went down. It was kind of away from all the action, and both of them on the floor. I never did see what happened. Ball fed into Rogers. Rogers got the ball, but he threw it up there, and he was fouled, tipped up. And a foul was called again on Pooh Powell, and Pooh has picked up his fourth in a hurry.
Oh, well, we certainly don't need that for UT Martin.
Oh, no.
The most consistent, most lethal outside threat for the Pacers. Pooh Powell, 3 3-pointers in the first half, 10 points overall. Goes to the bench with his fourth foul at 19:22 to play the basketball game.
Carlos Rogers, that you just threw that, slung that thing up there and went through. He missed that free throw. Rebound to Stephen Benton, and Benton will bring it on the attack. Benton gives it to Carlos Knox, who came in replacing Poon. He'll take it on the attack. There's a key outside, Philippe Phillips. Philippe holding out front. Now back to Ryan Bird. Comes up high and takes it. Right side to Marco Wright. DeMarco comes across the lane left to get to Carlos Knox. Puts up a 21-footer. It's missing. Rebound of a Damon Page, and Page rips it down and gets it to Tim Horton. He'll take it on the attack. Tim working right side, Philippe Phillips guarding him inside to Johnson, rims up, won't go, rebounded Bird, he's coming over his back for the rebound, two guys at equal opportunity, but I believe it's going to call those guys.
You know, we've heard so many coaches, Bill, claim that the first 5 minutes of the second half is so critical. I think so especially for the Pacers tonight, down 7 at the break, 9 now, a minute and a half into this second half. They need a bucket here on this possession.
Carlos Knox outside to Philippe Phillips, and Philippe over to Dickie Benton up on a high post. Over to Carlos Knox. Knox back out front to Philippe Phillips. He got the hot hand for a while the first half. And over to DeMarco Wright. On the wing, back to Philippe. Philippe working outside. Drive, pulls up, 15 footer. Up and good by Philippe. Boy, he's got to pick up the slack. Ball down the floor. Give it down here to Rico Beasley. He threw it away, but then the save. Damon Page in the battery bar. Johnson goes up on the press area. Picked up by UCM. Give it down to Benton. Benton lays it up, and he got hammered. Jim Johnson went up over the press table over there.
There a couple of good save attempts over there by Tennessee State. First on the baseline play, then over by Tim Barrington there. And Kevin Rogers, fourth center of the Pacers campus.
come that one go. And right now is the time we need those points, boy.
Well, we need them. We had a drought there in the first half, Bill. That got us in a 13-point hole. Fortunately, Philippe Phillips, Wayne Coop out, gets hot. Some three-point range gets back in contention. We don't need that here in the second half.
Two of boys of mine is a ticket. Benton Neal Jones takes it down and gets it. Rico Beasley working left corner. Rico looking down low, turns, picks up the dribble, needs some help, getting him looking for help, gets it to Jones. He traveled with the ball. Took a step to get the pass off. He had good D on him, and he walked with a 44-38 six-point lead. 17-58 to play in the basketball game at Carlos Knox. Right across the timeline. Knox looks left side, puts it back out to the lead. Phillips. Phillips bounce pass feed to Sidney Pitton up on a high post. Pitton turns into Knox. Knox going to put it up a three. Up in the roll, that won't go. Rebounded Beasley, comes out with it. Gives it to Neil Jones, and Jones is taking on the attack. Driving, penetrates, gets inside, pumps up a little six-footer, and they're going to let him get that close.
He did a good job of pulling up there before the defensive Ryan Bird got there. Short jumper in the lane.
That's 6 points now, left side, Carlos Knox, left wing. As they try to go through there, they almost tripped up DeMarco. Back outside to Carlos Knox, looks back out front. Gives it outside to Philippe Phillips, so DeMarco puts up a three-pointer, won't go. Rebound, he picked up here by Rico Beasley on the rebound for Genesee State. Over to Neil Jones, and Neil will take it on the attack. OVC game, playing Genesee State. They're about, what, number two, I guess, in OVC this year.
They've
right
won
now.
Eight of their last 10, Neil, and both of those two losses were the league-leading Murray State.
With the ball, Neil Jones, 15 footer right there, got it. Neil just coming him up. They let him go in there, and he's delivering from 68 feet in front of the basket. With the ball, it's Carlos Knox. He'll bring it across the timeline. Knox gives it to Philippe Phillips, and Phillips out front. Right side to Marco Wright, back over to Phillips. Phillips right side to Bird. Bird's holding on the right wing. Edges down a little bit, looking inside. Oh. Knox puts it up again. Good move there. Great shot by Carlos Knox, and a good feed by Ryan Bird. 48-40 bases. Failed by eight. With the ball, it's Neil Jones, and Jones will take it on the attack. Jones working left side. Jones looking in to Carlos Rogers down low. Carlos puts up a shot, won't go. Left red and left goes off the fingertips of Carlos Knox. And Rogers, he was having a battle with Rogers. 6'11" and 6 foot, Philippe's not 6 foot, I don't think. I think he's more like 5 feet.
You're right. Got a pound that way, though.
But he plays like a 6 footer, and I guess that's what's him. Pass out to Neil Jones by Tennessee State. Alley-oop, got low, get it in there to Damon Page. Miss, gets up and tipped in Carlos Knox. When you're 6'11", you can do that.
They go long arms, go up and over to the UCM defense.
50-40, 10-point lead in the second half of play. Pacers trailing by 10, driving left side. Philippe pulls up. Back outside to Carlos Knox. Head of deep back to Philippe out front. Looking down low to Carlos Knox. Baseline left corner. Rolls it back on the left wing. Lifts the cross foot. Gets it over Marco right on the wing. They're going out after him. Driving. But DeMarco looking. Down low to Carlos Knox. Right side. Back out to Philippe. Phillips puts up a three. Out there. Good by Philippe.
Got to pick up the slack. The foul on the bench.
Darwin down to Carlos Rogers. Puts it up. Puts it in. The foul. Solid line through. Oh, that's how about that for transition?
That's a 6'11 player running the floor, too.
And he got back in the hurry. Carlos Rogers going on the free throw line, shooting 65%. DeMarco Wright steps down. Jim Locum goes in for UTM. We need some threes out of Jim. Pacers just fit
so far tonight, Bill, is to put Carlos Rogers at the charity stripe. He certainly struggled there at 65%. Shooting on the season, I have him at 5 or 10.
That's correct. That one's up and good. He hits that one, got the three-point play the old-fashioned way. 53-43, 10-point lead now by Tennessee State. Collins knocks outside with it. Out there with the key looking. Jim Locum trying to post up. He got slammed out of there. Kicks it back to Philippe Phillips up front. He's going to guard him pretty close now because he's a three-point shooter. And Philippe is out front. Jim Horton backs off and he plays with the key on him. Jim Locum puts it up in the corner. Off the rim won't go. Bradley Clark Jones picks up the rebound. And Jones shovels it down the floor and they heard it. Tim Horton. Tim Horton down low to Rogers. Rogers gets it underneath. He walks the ball. And he got the pass off and he shot the second in the Damon Page and missed. That's a good basketball now. Straight across the timeline. There's Philippe Phillips. Puts up a three up and off the rim. Won't go. And it slaps around. It slaps out of bounds. And somebody hits the deck over there and the ball went out of bounds. And the Damon Page, he got the jab out. But Tennessee State. Rico Beasley comes in. Page goes out. 53-43, 10-point lead by Tennessee State. Carlos Knox gets the inbound pass. Carlos bounce back into Locum. He's open out there. Going to shoot a three. I mean, all the rim on that. He's flared up. Wouldn't go. And tied up on the rebound. Possession error goes the open end. He's usually a pretty good one. He can get his feet set. Well, he's had a couple opportunities in the last minute. He did get his feet set on both of them just off on both 3-point attempts. But he did get his feet set, but he had his shoulder kind of hanging when he went to the square. I think that's even about hit the front of that rim. But I don't know anything about shooting or anything. Anyhow, outside of the key, right side to the police Phillips down low to Burge, outside to Benton. Benton over to Carter Stocks, he's short underneath. He drills the ball down the floor, intercepted by Benton. Now to Carter Rogers, he threw a baseball pass. Down low to Benton. Benton takes his man, and he had him on back, and Carter Rogers bellied up to Benton, fouled him. Rogers has picked up his first foul tonight. All that fighting inside, he's only has one foul. What do you think?
Boy, that's what a good pump play for this one.
Yeah. You know, Jimmy didn't use the pump play perfectly that time.
Carlos Rogers did for it and picked up the foul.
Boy, Jimmy Benton is on the line. He's 2-4 to freeze the line tonight. This one's dropping good. Benton gets another. 3-5 to freeze the line. It's 53-44. Sidney with a free throw. Senior 6'6", 210 from Higgins, Boomer, 3. Got it and got it. 53-45, 8.8. 8. Neil Jones brings it up to get Neil drive, left side, pumps it up, off the good. They let Neil drive in there. Neil's delivering. He has 10 points, picks up from his hand. Elise Phillips with the ball, picks up the dribble, gets it back to Knox. Knox out front. Knox over to the bad pass to Locum. Locum on the right wing. Back over to Elise. And Talib took the three, missed. We better call us. Rogers gives it back to Neil Jones, and Jones will take it up. Boy, one of our prolific free throw shooters is sitting on the bench, loaded with four fouls, and that's the Wayne three-pound. Jones with it outside. Jones looking in. Jones back over to Horton. Horton with his drive. Pulls up, lays it up to the right side, and got it. Tim Horton took it to the hoop. He has 6 points. Knox takes it down. Out there to feed the beauty. Using right side. Here's the late Phillips, back out front to Sidney Benton. Benton outside, holding, looking just to Jim Locum. Rolls up high, takes it, Jim backing out. Looking to the up, right side for late Phillips. He's going to take him to three. Good by Phillips. Got to have it. That's 5-3 for him tonight.
An important hurt here in front of us, Bill.
Right in front as they were coming down the floor. Yeah, whistle. 57-48, 9-point lead, 13-11 to play.
He'll be holding his side.
Well, the elbow there, or he has to go out if the coaches come on the floor. He has to go out. There may be some time. No, they're not taking time. I don't know. They might. Here comes Gurnell in for him. Roy Gurnell is coming in. So they get Tim Horton down the bench. Did you see what happened?
I did not see what happened. I saw them all running down the floor after Philippe Phillips' fifth three-pointer.
Neil Jones will take it on the attack. Neil moves it down, works the right side. Neil, Janelle got a screen for him. Outside to Rico Beasley out there to see Rico lifts him up against the Rogers. Rogers down low, back out front to the Janelle. He walked. He took a step. Janelle traveled with the basketball turnover. That time, good defense. Janelle fell loose in the CCM step. And just at a critical time, they brought two fouls back with the four fouls. 13 minutes to go in his basketball game. And UCM down only 9. At the time, they know they've got to get a run here somewhere right along about now. Ball up on the high post to Sidney Benton. Benton with it outside, gives it to Lee Phillips. Now, fast three down to Robinson. Benton rolls it up and won't go.
Tipped up and kicked in by Benton. There's a take and roll, and Houston gets the garbage.
57-50 Pacers. Let's fail by 7. Trying to get a run, trying to get back in this thing. With a basketball moving down Neil Jones. Jones working left on the left wing. Jones with it. Left side. Top foot pass to Rico Beasley, right wing. Beasley down low to Gurnell. Gurnell looking for help, gives to Jones. Jones puts up his shot. Jones puts in a shot. Neil Jones is the man the hour for him. He has 12 points, 8 to pass. With it driving, Philippe Phillips. Put a little pop underneath. Got it, missed. Bradley Barr slapped it right on the back. And it's Bradley Barr. Down the ball, Jim Logan. Kick it out to Buse. Buse to free foul. Free foul up to Hennessy. Puts up a three. Off of him, won't go. We got it picked up here by Rico Beasley. Down to Neil Jones, and Jones driving. Kicks it right side, gives it to Beasley outside. Puts up a three, puts in a three. Boy, that's nice. That's 4-3 for him tonight. 62-50 score. Boy, did you see the hustle and the scramble on the deck a few moments ago?
Already hustled by Philippe. Could have been Jimmy Locum. He
was the loose ball. He made fellas right there. There's going to be some timeout on the floor while we get this timeout. Let's just take a break on the Facebook Sports Network. Back here at Trace Arena, and I tell you, the bomb bomb girls got all over the TV screen that time on WLJT TV.
It's a good seat in here, Bill. I know why you do these games.
You like them down here, don't you, Bill? You're close to all the action, I tell you. Well, we're here with 62-50 Pacers down the cover. 3-point shot to go after all the trouble we had. We deserve that for them, you know. Lou Powell back out to Steve Wright, right out there to Steve backing out and looking in. Right side gives it to Carlos Knox, knocks back at the Lou Powell, thinks his man got the shot up there, 50. Good by Carlos Knox, by Lou Powell. And Carlos Knox, he banks it in there. Nice bank. 62-52, bases down by Jim. Neil Jones on the attack. Neil takes it down the right side, drives baseline, pulls up, kicks it back into Rogers. And Rogers is flat footed, slapped away, picks it up. Time he didn't win the argument because that lady was holding Bird as a beauty. I think it was all a beauty. Locum is going to inbound the basketball. Locum and Powell and Malik Phillips and Bird and he's been getting in the ballgame for UPM. Rodgers is going to sit down for a while. How about him out? Dick Johnson is in there on the post. Don't get away but 2 inches. Not quite as mobile as Carlos Rodgers, but a big fella, 250. A lot bigger man than Carlos. Malik Phillips left side to Ryan Burge. Burge on the left wing. Back outside Malik Phillips. Murphy pulls up. Got a good by Malik. Price looked outside, just to Harton back out there. Foul down low. Holding on Burge. Burge has picked up his third. You know, I wasn't watching Horton speak tonight. Just about every time, he'll just about walk, take a step backwards, sideways to get geared up.
You're exactly right. And a couple of times he's been called for it, but more times than not, he has.
Well, the ref is going over to talk with the scorekeeper at the table. Need a mic over there to find out what's going on. Ball will be in done by Tim Horton. Horton out to Washington. Washington got up. Watson works down on the right wing, looks down low, Horton breaks out of there, and Smith gives it outside. Rico Beasley looks up a shot off the rim, won't go. Rebound here by Pooh Powell, he's running. Pooh is going to bring it across the timeline. Stop, shot, side, puts up a three off the rim, won't go. Rebound for Burge, rebound with a shot. Can't go!
Ryan Burge first through the line. Burge did something smart there, Bill, and he was awful quick with a stick back with a presence inside like Johnson, a 6'9", 250-pounder, and some of the other things he faced back. They got to be quick when you make that decision.
Well, the basketball is Watson. He almost runs a pivot foot, too. Watson is now right side. Horton puts up a three, knocks it home. It's good. The foul call. Basket was good. Well, Jamel's jumping off the rebound position underneath. I think he's good. So it's 76-61, a 15-point lead, 6:26 to play in the ballgame, and they still got some time to raise
the worst of the 3-pointers. Certainly, there's plenty of time left.
Well, Lee Phillips out there to call a stop. Stop that penalty. We need to get a big three, right here. So no. Sidney Benton got that to knock. Knocked outside here, but he's looking right. He's going to pump it up. Knox is going to be fouled. It got into him as he got the shot away. I believe Neil Jones may have got it. Neil Jones picked up his third as a shooting violation. He's going in the ballgame, and I think he's going to replace Jim Lopez in the year. Hollis Knox is going on the line. He's 2-2 to leave the line tonight. 6:08 to play in the ballgame. Three shots will be taken by Hollis Knox. There's a 3-point attempt as he got fouled. It's good. Boy, this is a time to catch up, and we need to hit all three of them here. Pace of feet.
Really important to stop some of this lead down with the clock arrested here. 6:08 still to play. A 13-point game now, 76-63. We can get it in a dozen.
And Tyler Fox is 4-4 the line. Standing up there for his third free throw attempt. This one's up. That was good. 5-5 at the line tonight. 76-64. Back to it at 12. Jones long pass out here to Rico Beasley. Guns in the three. Boy, just as you do something here. Exactly. Again, he has 6 threes tonight. Blue foul out front. Left side to Carlos Knox. Knox went with it. Penetrate. Keeps it back to...
guys a chance when you bring that ball down around your waist.
You're right. Beasley got inside that three-point line. Got it. He had better stay outside that circle. He hits better out there. Off the call is Knox. Knox driving baseline. Comes back with a shot. And he's rolled in.
Oh, yes.
As Carlos Knox got fouled going to the bucket.
Well, you can see Carlos Knox playing with so much confidence, Bill. He had a career high getting 15 taking the Pacers win on Monday night, breaking a 10-game losing streak. And he's played awfully well here again tonight.
Carlos, Tim Horton got the foul, and a chance for the three-point play shoot by Carlos Knox. He's 5-5 in the line. Has 16 points tonight. You know, he's the kind of guy who gets better with his playing time.
Cal Luther tells me he's probably the best shooter on the team.
He got it.
That's a pretty high company there with Billy Phillips through foul.
Well, you know, sometimes the pure shooters, and when he gets the playing time like he's got, he's come on real strong. With it right side is Jones. Jones out front shoves it quickly to Rico Beasley. He's got the hot hand. They want him to shoot the three. Neil Jones back outside to Davis. Davis
There's an 18-footer taken near by Jones. Missed. Rebounded Pooh Powell. He brings it down. He comes across the timeline. Faces get it down in a hurry, too. Jones gets back with him. Looks, works outside, gives it to Khalid Phillips. Going to take him a three. Up and out won't go. Rebounded. It went off a stick of his hands. Jones picks it up. Jones will bring it across the timeline. Down the right side, gives to Horton. Horton puts up a 3-point and won't go. Rebounded by Benton, and Benton running. He'll bring it across the timeline. Benton lobs right side. Pooh Powell. Pooh got him a three. Pooh from the right wing. 79-70 down within nine right now with 4:24 to play the basketball game. And time is going to be taken. Timeout on the floor. 79-70. UTM trails by nine. Let's just take a 60 on the face of Sports Network.
160 from New York City. Good
job. Let's shoot it, fellas. Let's get the flow of things. He walks it down, trying to shoot it off a little bit here. As Neil Jones looking right side. Jones down low in the face of Rogers. Rogers puts it up, won't go. Tipped up by Rogers, tipped in by Rogers, and the foul is called. As Carlos Rogers, once again, got fouled and can't. Vicky Benton picks it up, his third, going on the free throw line for the three-point play. The old-fashioned way will be Carlos Rogers.
UTM 12 of 31, 39% of the second half, 16 of 30 for Tennessee State, 53%. The Pacers 7 of 8 for the charity strike for 87%, 18 to 16 rebounding edge for Tennessee State.
Rogers' free throw was good. Carlos Knox will bring it down for the Pacers. Working right, backing out of there. Heavy traffic there. Khalid Phillips over to Pooh Powell on the left wing. Back to Carlos Knox up high. Carlos with it out front in the corner of the booth. There they have it. Going jumping. Horton with it in the corner. Horton inside to Carlos Rogers. Rogers on the following shot. And he put it in and he got decked.
Yeah, that's a big time shot there by the future NBAer.
Falling away. And he did it. He kind of shoot it across the floor. And he needs an option for that too. But that's it looks better if he sprawled on the floor, didn't he? He's a good ball player. We don't mean to belittle his efforts one iota. That foul is called. Number 32, Burns got it. Burns has picked up four fouls, and he just picked up three, so it's good. He got the three-point play the old-fashioned way. 85-73, 12-point lead here by Tennessee State. Two fouls gives it to Khalid Phillips. Khalid out front to Carlos Knox, there's a deep basket down low to Burns. Back at the Carlos Knox, driving, penetrating, getting inside. He's going to put it up there, it's going to miss, and they're going to battle Parks. It's going to go in the corner, and they're still stumbling around Parks. Left back in, picks up the rebound. These are just the Jones, and Jones are lost. Neil Jones will take 2:35 to play in the ballgame. 73-85, faces down by 12. Jones on the right wing, Jones looking inside. He calls Rogers back to Tim Horton. Get inside, 15 for the Horton. Up and out won't go. Rebound of the 50 big. Benton throws it quickly down to Carlos Knox. Knox lays it up and in for two.
That was a great kick by Carlos Knox. Ahead of the back there for the UGD.
He'd be a good wide receiver, wouldn't
he? Tom McCreary sitting right behind us. He may pass that on to him.
That's it. That's the only way you settle a lot of those. Neil Jones battling for the basketball. And it went out of bounds. And I don't know, was there a foul call? I think it was. And they're going to call it on Carlos Knox.
Tennessee State in the bonus, I think, number 7 in the second half on UTM.
I thought I was going to catch that one for a moment.
I wasn't going to catch anything. You get the train out of here when I saw those two horses coming at me.
Neil Jones on the line. Neil shooting 75% from free throw line for Tennessee State Tigers. Got him. Tim got one call. Bird grabs the rebound. He gets it to Khalid Phillips and the Pacers hurry down. Khalid working outside with the ball. Khalid gives it to Pooh Powell on the right wing. Pooh looking down low to Burge, and once again to Burge, back out front to Benton, Benton over to Carlos Knox, puts up a three, 24 feet away, but rebounded here by Rico Beasley. Beasley gets to Jones, and Jones is taking on the attack. 1:45 to play in the ballgame, 10-point lead by Tennessee State. Neil Jones working right, Carlos Knox guarding him and fouling him. That was a touchman that guy, that son.
You may want him at the foul line right now, Bill. Shooting only 65% for the season at Tennessee State, and especially Rogers is seeing him struggle there tonight. Johnson 1-2, and Jones missed his only earlier attempt about 15 seconds ago.
1:39 to play in the basketball game. This one's up and good by Neil Jones. He's 1-2 of the line, shooting 75% on the year.
You know, Neil Jones has come off the bench at guard. This is a senior. He lost his starting role. And yeah, he's doing the job tonight. He hit that one.
Going to ask you guys, especially in the second half.
Yeah, yeah. Cole's got a compliment in, I guess, at halftime. He said, you got to deliver, buddy. Well, they poop out down to Benton. Benton puts up a three, and it out will not go. They battle for the ball. Picked up here by Rico Beasley. Out front. Rico gets it to Neil Jones. It's Jones will take it on the attack. Jones comes across the timeline. His father's not picking up from the crowd, moving toward the exit because of the snow and ice and everything. I don't know how far anybody will go tonight. We're going to check the weather conditions out there after a while. As Jones with it outside, father's not working out front. Jones is trapped over the right side into the Horton. Horton back out front. Whips it down low there to Carlos Rogers. Deep right corner. And he puts up a long three-pointer missing. Bradley Farr picked up in the poop pile. He came out of nowhere. He's driving through. Lays it up. And he's a foul by Carlos Rogers.
Well, if I'm using him, that's where I want Carlos Rogers shooting the basketball out there about 23 feet from the goal. But if I'm Frankie Allen, I think I might have a word with that one, man.
Frankie, I think, jumped up and he's whipped by as he's coming down the sidelines. I think he did have a word with him. Probably Carlos didn't hear him. He's coming down so fast.
Carlos didn't want to hear him.
No. The way Poop Powell's one of two, getting over 80% of the free throw line. He's on the line now. He hits that one. He's 2 of 3. Big important time to hit him. As the base is now back to within 11. You never say die, Miss Green. Not over to the fat lady things and all that good stuff. This is up pretty good. 3 or 4 of the line to Wayne Poop Powell. 87-77. Jones lobs down the floor to Rogers. Rogers lays it up. But I think they're going to call goals in there. May have been a foul before that. Did you see Felipe Phillips get up? That's the 6 footer you were talking about there. And he got up and slapped the ball off the square on the bucket. Then he got the foul. That basket didn't count. He was fouled before he got there. I'll tell you, Felipe swatted that thing. We're going to say it's on the bad with Archie here, but he really, as you said, got up. Carlos Rogers is on the line. Got it. And rimmed that one go. Benton grabs the rebound. Sidney Benton gets it down the floor to Poop Powell and the bringing of the attack. Driving, right side, pulls up, looks for help, keeps it back up front to Lee Phillips. He turns up a long, well, 25-footer!
Does he have some range, or does he have range?
Has spring in his legs, did he not? 89-80, bases down to 9, 34.8 seconds left to go. This timeout, less than 60 on the Bases Sports Network.
Next time on Austin City Limits. Country star John Anderson.
I can't believe you're gone. I thought you could do no wrong. But I fell in the water as you all come. And I want to be.
And songwriter Billy Dean. Saturday night at 7 o'clock.
On the airplanes of the Serengeti.
Back court, so they want to get called in a hurry. I was just looking here. Who was that foul on? I called it Knox. Knox picked up his third foul. I was just looking after tonight. The Pacers go on the road. We'll be at Austin Peay, Clarksville next Wednesday night. Take a week off. Then we'll be at Moorhead on February the 19th, Saturday and Monday, Eastern Kentucky, in Richmond, Kentucky. So we got a on the road, we'll be back here with Southeast Missouri on February the 26th and Murray State February 28th and lined up on the road March 2nd at Evansville.
And UT Martin played well here in this building. Neil, they don't have a lot to show for it as far as the victory column. But once again tonight, a very athletic gift that Tennessee State comes in here and has to play hard to beat the Pacers.
They do. I tell you what, we've been very competitive, I think, all year. I don't know of any team that could have blown us completely away, you know. He's been competitive with him, and I think this team is coming. He had to give it some time, a couple of more. Yeah, he missed both free throws. Neil Jones did. Pacers grabbed the ball. Poop Powell comes down the floor. Poop puts up a three. He was really contested there. Goes out of bounds. Trying to get the save was Ryan Bird. Got it back into Locum, but they said he was out of bounds when he got the save. So 25 seconds left to play the ball game. It's going to be Tennessee State basketball. What one official out front called something?
He said the ball was partially deflected. What it was it, he hit Powell on the wrist, and now Powell picked up a technical foul.
I don't know whether Powell picked it up or maybe Bob Ward picked it up. Who did pick it up?
Powell picked it up because it's his fifth personal.
Well, we got a T, and we got a they're waiting to prove Powell. They fouled out with 25.3 seconds left to play. I tell you what, there was a lot of Pooh ended up with 22 points tonight. I'll tell you that. Jim Locum is back in. So shooting on the free throw line, we'll go 30 Jenkins is in the ballgame shooting. That technical, got it.
30 Jenkins just checked into the ballgame to shoot the technical foul.
Shooting 80% free throw line. Maybe we checked in, reckon. Got it, yeah. Sure, sure, the line had good form. Now he may check it. Now he's going to stay in.
Going to stay in to leave.
Somebody said, you the man. Beasley gives it back to Jones. Jones way out front. Jones goes all by and rolls the base with a 200 jam. That's his first basket this half. He has 11 points, though. Jim Locum with the ball. 93-80 score. Outside. 5-footer again here by Philippe Smith. Rebounded Rogers. Rogers takes it down, works right side. He's going to put a three from way out there, missing. And Bird grabs the rebound. The ball game is over. 93. I'm talking to Karen.
But after signing a deal for approximately $65 million, we should change it to dollar bill to get Penny. Brothers, hey, check out the shit.
Where did the nickname Penny come from?
I hate to say it, but that's a nickname that my grandmother gave me when I was very young. And the reason why she said she gave it to me is that I was pretty as Penny. So I've never liked to say that, though.
I mean, that's kind of a goofy nickname.
That's grandma. Yes. Let's see. Playing in the NBA is so different than college. Who's the toughest man you've had to face?
Without a doubt, I think Joe Dumars. We're at Detroit. Early in the season, and I was trying to guard him, and I got three fouls in a row against Joe Dumars. I had to sit and miss the whole first half, and I was over there thinking, man, this guy's tough.
Yeah, what is it about him? What did he keep throwing at you?
I don't know. He kept driving the ball on me. I never could stop him. I mean, that's the only person in the NBA right now that who I've had the most problems with.
Yeah. Magic said to me one time, he said, when I watch him play, I feel like I'm looking in the mirror. What do you think he means by that?
I don't know. I guess the past would go to, I was with him this summer, and told me the same thing. He's like, man, you remind me of myself so much. I'm the height, I'm gonna run the point guard position, like the more showtime style of play.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You're with Shaquille. Somebody said he might have had a little bit to do with you actually being there. You know, like,
I think so. We came here for the movie Blue Chips, and we were on Paramount Studios, and we played basketball together every day. And he started liking the style of play that we were playing together, you know, reminding each other of a Kareem and Magic type deal. Mm-hmm. And he said, I might want to ask Orlando to take another look at you, because I had already been down once in a tryout to work out for the team, and it didn't work out that well. So he said, I'll ask you, have you back down again. And that's what happened, and I think he's a good part in that.
Let me ask a question. This may have an obvious answer, but somebody who goes to Orlando and the tryout doesn't work good, then he goes back and they give him $65 million. What happened that first time, or who was smoking crack that second time? It's like, that's a big difference.
It is. It was so intimidating. I mean, I went in there the first time, and like, the head coach left, the general manager left, and nobody watched me work out. So I told Steele what happened, because we were doing the movie while the first time I went down there. I said, man, nobody watched me. He's like, okay, I can handle that. You know, Shaquille, nobody's going to really tell him no trash. So he called and got me down there again. So it was good for me.
Yeah. You've mentioned this movie a couple of times. Did you have to take action yet?
No, I didn't. I think the thing that happened was Kevin Benton, he was in the movie also. When I first came down, he picked me up from the airport. He said, I have somebody He wants to work with you with the script. He's Larry G, the guy that played the bar.
Yeah.
And Revenge of the Nerd. He helped me out that night, and he stayed on the script for about 2 hours, going back and forth. And he played to Keith Bell, who was Nick Nolte, and I played with him, played my own character, and it worked out.
Yeah.
Hey, Marlon, we got another segment? Let's take a commercial, and then give me a script from Blue Chips. I'll be back with Anthony Hardaway. Anthony Hardaway, who has a movie called Blue Chips that opens nationwide February 18th. Shaquille O'Neal is also in the movie. Nice, nice film. Let's show them a clip.
Coach, I need to talk to you. Sure. Go ahead. Coach, I'm homesick. Homesick? Well, let me tell you something, Bruce. Every year, a couple of guys come in here and tell me they're homesick, and everything is going to be fine once the season starts, you see.
No, Coach, I don't belong here. I mean, I've never ran the motion offense. That's not my style. I need to be in a 1-4 offense where I can handle the ball and do stuff to keep. I mean, that's my style.
But let me tell you something. No, I don't know if it's the right place. I can't even get a smile on.
Coach, I don't belong here. I guess what I'm really trying to say is, if I left school, would my mom lose her house job? You know, one thing I like about you, when I look back into your background, there was a point where you were having some grade problems, and you got busy. It was real important to you. You brought your average up and everything.
I think the thing that happened to me in high school is I was very poor. You know, I was a high school star. I didn't have to do anything. I mean, my teachers, you know, they let me get away with murder. So I think it caught up with me, you know, going to college because I didn't pass those two. And then once I got into college, it wasn't the fact that I could never do any work. I just didn't want to do it. You know, and I got caught up with girls and everything. And once my grandmother, you know, we had a serious talk when I was freshman in college. She said, this is the way you have to do it because you can't rely on anybody else. And came out making a dangerous 3 semesters in a row.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Well, for kids out there to get wet. Also, there was a period in your life. What happened when you didn't stop in the foot?
Well, this is pretty rough. And day after I had just got finished, you know, playing basketball, and this car kept passing by my home, and so I was already outside, and the car stopped, and approached us and said, could we find a certain neighborhood, and we knew what was about to happen, so we just tried to get him away as soon as possible, so we could just try to run or get away or something, and they pulled guns out on us and said, hey, just get on the ground, and took all our valuables, and then they hopped back in the car, and then they drove off, they started shooting back to where we were. I mean, I know I wasn't going to chase him, so I don't know why he started shooting, but the bullet ricocheted off the ground and hit me in the foot. From then on, you know, it went down here.
Yeah. Does that foot ever give you any problems?
Not anymore. Once I got shot, they couldn't operate and take the bullet out immediately. They had to leave it in for like 6 months. So I had to walk around with a bullet in my foot. And people started making jokes about, could I go through the airport? Could I, you know, and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess that probably motivated you to get to another neighborhood and succeed or something.
I saw the car passing by. I mean, I wasn't noticing it. It made me notice a lot more things nowadays. Because if I'd have been aware of the car, you know, it's passed like 6 or 7 times, and it probably wouldn't have happened. I probably would have went ahead and went into the house before anything happened. But it made me realize that I can't go out anymore because I was going out all times tonight, going to different nightclubs. And it taught me not to just even go out anymore, just be aware of things.
Well, continued success. We'll be watching you, and we're going to go check out the movie. Okay? Right. Here's Grandma. We all said hello.
Anthony Hardaway!
Wing looking back outside to Poo Pal. That now to DeMarco right left wing. Looking down low, they run Philippe through and had JT on him. He cut him back door, had a cutter backside. Now back on DeMarco right from the right side. DeMarco went to shoot, blocked away from him. Picked up here by Davis in the corner. Davis kicks it to Jones, and Jones will bring it on the attack. Boy, they play a good tough D. Jones outside, they're going to let him shoot that and off the rim won't go. Rebounded by Jones. Jones right. He caught the ball, though, and he should have had a
get away with a walk.
He got by with a shot. Jones knows it. He's grinning. He says, yes, it did. And he got it to Rogers, and Rogers drew the foul. He did get by with a trap. Foul was called on Chris Buesen. 17 fouls on Buesen, and Carlos Rogers is going to go on the line. He has 2 field goals and 3 free throws, 3 out of 5 at the free throw line. 4:07 to play, first half. Carlos Rogers shot it, and Carlos Rogers missed it.
He's the reigning Ohio Valley Player of the Year and the preseason choice for the same honor.
He's 3 of 6 at the free throw line, shooting 65% at the free throw line on the year. This one's up, back of the rim, won't go. Battle far, picked up here by Pooh. They battle for the basketball. Pooh keeps it alive, and they said Pooh stepped out of bounds.
He's claiming he was pushed there. Pooh claiming he was pushed there, and I know he was.
I tell you that. Carlos Rogers is not doing very good at the free throw line. Gurnell will inbound the basketball from side back court.
Rogers shoots 65% for the season from the charity stripe, 121 of 186.
Coach Kyle Luther over there very reflective and follow some instructions out.
When you see Cal Luther come off with that jacket, you know he means business over there. He came off with that very early in this basketball game.
You know that action is hot and heavy. Bob Ward is over there talking to the official about something. They get squared away, I guess. Gurnell will inbound the basketball to Neil Jones, and Neil will bring it on the attack. 4-foot-13 to play in the first half of play. With the basketball is Horton out to have the key. He's being pressured by Philippe Phillips over to Neil Jones' right side. Neil looking in to Rogers. Down low with the shoot, blocked away, got it back, slapped out of his hands, and goes out of bounds off his fingertips, and Rogers is upset over the call.
He was triple-teamed down low, got the ball inside about 2 foot from the bucket. May have been too close to the bucket that time. On the second chance, he was stripped away. The ball went off him and back to the face.
Chris Houston was trying to come through a two-man trap. He's trying to split it, and got him tied up, and they kicked the ball, so we'll get another 30 seconds. Houston inbounds quickly to Philippe Phillips. Down the floor to DeMarco Wright. They hurry bound down behind him. Picks up the dribble, gives it to Buesen. Back outside to Philippe Phillips. Puts up a three. Knocked it home. Philippe got it.
Got to have that from Philippe.
Yes, sir. 23, 33 paces down by 10. Neil Jones will bring it down. Neil will come across the timeline with it. Comes down the floor, works down the right side. Neil drives to drive the baseline. Backs out. He couldn't go in the tall trees. Over to Tim Horton out front. Tim has the key holding. Got to work right, looks low to Rogers and posting him up and holding him down there. He's posting up Buesen. There was a traveling call and a turnover, Tennessee State.
He drug the pivot foot right there in front of our desk.
And right in front of that official. He was eyeballing that thing pretty closely. So, you know, they're human too, just like they had in the women's game, wasn't it? Sometimes you wonder with the athleticism that they have as Philippe Phillips will bring it across the timeline. Now outside to DeMarco Wright. Now gives left wing to Poupal down deep left baseline corner to Chris Houston. Back out front to Sidney Benton. Out to the key. Gurnell right on him. Out to Philippe. Puts one in the NBA range and he got it.
He's getting a feeling.
He may get in the zone, hopefully. Neil Jones brings it left side. Jones looks inside. He gets down to Rogers and triple team him. The ball slapped away and goes out of bounds. And touch plays, they say, by the Pacers. Oh, they triple-teamed him that time. Rogers, we're talking about the big fella down in the paint.
Well, Philippe Phillips can step up and make that three-pointer on a consistent basis, Bill. Certainly, that takes the pressure off Poupal, Carlos Knox, and DeMarco Wright, and the Pacers aren't so one-dimensional offensively. Big, big factor for UTN.
Curtis Davis in the ballgame, replacing Gurnell. Back to Neil Jones up high. And Jones working out to the key. Now flips it left side to Horton. Horton on the left wing, being pushed, tries to drive baseline. He shut off, can't go. He walks for the ball. Tim drugged the pivot foot. I didn't get a foul. No, a charging foul on Tim Horton.
Second straight possession, Tim Horton turned it over.
Well, he was shoving a guy off along the baseline, and I thought for a while he may have traveled, but that Philippe Phillips with the ball, he gets it down to Sidney Benton, and Benton will bring it across the timeline, down left corner to DeMarco Wright. Back out to Philippe Phillips, puts up a three. Good! He's hot. When you're hot, when you're hot, you're hot. When you're not, you're not. Right now he's hot. Feed the hot hand, 33-29, Pacers trailed by four, and the crowd gets into it. Neil Jones, baseline, right side. Neil Jones kicks it back inside to Rogers, and a foul has been called on Sidney Benton, and they were just battling for the basketball, and gets another foul. Was it Sidney or was it Pooh?
I think it was Pooh.
Pooh. Because I didn't touch him, Mr. Bell.
I tell you who is touching something, and that's Philippe Phillips. He's really stroking it right now. Those last two, Bill, were for NBA. Those were 25-footers.
I hope some of the NBA guys are here, scouts here tonight, see that, you know.
They may make a note or two about number 22 of UT
right.
Martin.
Right. See, Carlos, maybe, you know, sometimes that happens.
That's exactly right.
Carlos Rogers on the line. He's been there all night, shot it and got it. Shooting 65%, but he hasn't done that tonight. I hope he doesn't get in a flow. They can hear voices all over this place. Good crowd on this snowy cold night. Shot it, got it. And 2 of 2 there. 35-29, 6-point lead here by Tennessee State. Carlos Knox moves it on the attack. After Philippe Phillips has the key working right side. Philippe on the right wing looking, needs some help. Gets to Sidney Benton out front. Benton gives it back over to Philippe Phillips outside. And there was a foul called on was that?
Illegal screen, I think, maybe on sending business.
Sidney is a marked man right now. He has his second foul. And as Ryan Burge will get in for Sidney, he picked up two. Don't want him to get three right now. It's 2:03 to play first half. And we still got some time to go in this one. This way it's going is to be anybody's ballgame. Nobody's really showed a dominance here yet.
In the first 18 minutes, Bill, UT Martin has made 7 3-point field goals and only 3 from 2-point range.
As Tim Horton missed the first of the 1-1. And on the rebound, fighting part went off the fingertips of Chris Houston, so it will be inbounded here by Tim Horton
on the Tennessee State basket. Horton will inbound. Horton gives it back outside to Neil Jones, and Jones with it works out to the deep. Jones working left to Davis outside, puts up a long three, and Davis did that to us up in Nashville. As his first three, 38-29, Pacers trailed by 9. Khalid Phillips over to Chris Houston. Hands it to DeMarco Wright. DeMarco Wright, Carlos Knox, right side down low in the paint. Hook shot there by Houston, missing. Rebounded Horton, picked up here, giving it to Jones. Jones on the run. He'll bring it down, stops outside. Looks right side to Horton, up to Rogers, took the shot, and Brooke got the good roll and popped in there for two. That's one of the three field goals to come for Carlos this first half. And he's been on the free throw line all night. Khalid Phillips with the ball, working outside, man-to-man pressure by Tennessee State. Gives it to DeMarco Wright, stop for the 10, put it good by DeMarco. DeMarco Wright did a good job, rubbing off that high pick. Phillips hit him for the easy 12-footer. 40-31, Pacers down by 9, 108 to play in the first half. Don't forget at halftime, we'll be talking to Coach John McGrill. We're going to have some kind of ceremony here at halftime. Davis with another long three, he's missing that one. We got a Carlos Knox, the foul call.
11 had a hold of Carlos Knox, sitting there behind as Neil Jones. That would cost him 15 yards on Saturday afternoon.
That's a holding right there, sure enough. He wasn't going to let him go anywhere. He had grabbed that jersey just how long ago he left. He's going to sit down for a while. And coming back in the ballgame with 50 pitches. We will get a 1+1 here, won't we? Yes.
Carlos Knox on the line. Carlos has 5 points.
He's an 80% free throw shooter.
He's a 6'2 freshman of Dayton, Ohio. A true freshman. He hit that one. Thanks, we needed that 8-point difference here now in the first half. 58 seconds inside of a minute. As Carlos gets another free throw. Carlos shot it, and Carlos got it. 2-2 at the line. 40-33, 7-point lead. With the ball now on the attack as Greg Watkins, he'll bring it down. Greg comes across the timeline, works the right side. They run Horton inside to Big Rogers. They double team him outside to Watkins. Watkins in the corner to Davis. Davis rolling out front. He'll put up that three from way out there. Starting him is Sidney Benton, left side to Rico Beasley. Beasley back out to Davis. Davis now flips to Horton. Horton in there. Horton is going to drive. Horton is going to take baseline. Going to put it up. It's missing. Battle far underneath. Picked up here by Khalid Phillips. He scoops up the garbage. And he gets it off here to Carlos Knox. 20 seconds on the clock. Faces bounce fast feed down to DeMarco Wright. Backing out. Spinning. On the wing, comes right back on the attack, takes it under, and he had the ball slapped away and slapped out of bounds. It's going to be facing basketball. It was blocked away by Carlos Rogers.
He was showing no fear taking the ball inside of the big fella. That's 3 blocks for Rogers.
That half, they can tell you, big man. You may be NBA first round, but you don't intimidate me. Marco Wright will inbound ball. I tell you, a team coach like Cal Lizard don't get intimidated.
You're exactly right.
Ball was kicked as he inbounded it. If you get intimidated, you sit over there and hold his hand.
It's real close.
Yeah, right. Just the course of the game. As DeMarco will inbound the ball, looking inside to Benton, gives it a knock. Knox takes it in the corner, being pressured. Spin comes out there. Carlos with it, popped up a 15. Put it good by Carlos Knox. 35 paces down to 5. Driving. Watkins lays it up, won't go, tipped up and tipped in, and it's going to be good. As Carlos Rogers got the tip in as the buzzer went off. Son of a gun, how about them apples? 40, 35. And Coach Bob Ward is over discussing, as he wants to say, wave it off, wave it off. But he didn't wave it off, I don't think, and the pictures are still out there. We'll stay right here for just a moment. Okay. We're going to take a 2-minute break. We'll be back here in 2 minutes on the Pacers Sports Network.
WLJT TV Channel 11, Lexington Martin, Public Television.
Play of this ball game out to Rico Beasley, right side to Damon Page, puts up a three-pointer off the back of the rim, bounces up over the backboard, and it's going to go out of bounds, going to be Pacer basketball. We're down to seven, Pacers are down to seven, we're within 10, we're in the second half of play. Boo Powell will walk it down. He'll come across the timeline with it. Works left to DeMarco right, DeMarco working left wing, holding out front, there you see.
Did he travel? Is that what he called?
That was a call out there. No, the kind of mistake that'll drive a coaching staff mad. That's just an unforced turnover, Bill. There was no pressure on DeMarco Wright. He just drove a pivot foot there and turned the ball over.
With the ball, Horton will take it on the attack, working right side, picked up by Malik Phillips, sends it back over to Carlos Rogers out to Tim Horton. He puts up a three, it's off the rim, won't fall. Rebound to Johnson. Two guys hit the deck. Pooh Powell goes down, and so does 24 Damon Page goes down. Pooh Powell drew the foul.
That's his third one, and he
went down. It was kind of away from all the action, and both of them on the floor. I never did see what happened. Ball fed into Rogers. Rogers got the ball, but he threw it up there, and he was fouled, tipped up. And a foul was called again on Pooh Powell, and Pooh has picked up his fourth in a hurry.
Oh, but we certainly don't need that for G.P. Martin.
Oh, no.
The most consistent, most lethal outside threat for the Pacers. Pooh Powell, 3 3-pointers in the first half, 10 points overall. Goes to the bench with his fourth foul at 19:22 to play the basketball game.
Carlos Rogers, that you just threw that, slung that thing up there and went through. He missed that free throw, rebound, kick to Benton, and Benton will bring it on the attack. Benton gives it Carlos Knox, he came in replacing Pooh, and he'll take it on the attack. There's a D outside, Philippe Phillips. Philippe holding out front, now back to Ryan Bird, comes up high and takes it, right side to Marco Wright. DeMarco comes across the lane, left to Pooh. Carlos Knox puts up a 21-footer, it's missing, rebounded by Damon Page, and Page rips it down and gets it to Tim Horton, he'll take it on the attack. Tim working right side, Philippe Phillips guarding him inside to Johnson, rams up, won't go, rebounded Bird, he's coming over, he's back for the rebound, two guys at equal opportunity, but I believe it's going to call those guys.
You know, we've heard so many coaches, Bill, claim that the first 5 minutes of the second half is so critical. I think so, especially for the Pacers tonight, down seven at the break, nine now, a minute and a half into the second half, they need a bucket here on this possession.
Carlos Knox outside to Philippe Phillips, and Philippe over to Ziggy Benton up on a high post. Over to Carlos Knox. Knox back out front to Philippe Phillips. He got the hot hand for a while the first half. And over to DeMarco Wright. On the wing, back to Philippe. Eight working outside. Drive, pulls up, 50-footer. Up and good by Philippe. Boy, he's got to pick up the slack. Ball down the floor. Give it down here to Rico Beasley. He threw it away. But then the save, Damon Page, and it badly far. Johnson goes up on the press area. Picked up by UTM. Give it down to Benton. Benton lays it up. And he got hammered and fouled. Jim Johnson went up over the press table over there.
A couple of good save attempts over there by Tennessee State. First on the baseline play, then over by Jim Barrington there. And Kevin Rogers, the sports editor of the Pacers, campus newspaper.
He almost got him in his lap over there, didn't he?
He's laughing about it now. He must have caught it. If he hadn't, I don't think he'd have been laughing too much.
No, but he didn't have to smack on 250 pounds on his training to get the number of that truck, didn't he? And Ziggy Benton's going on the line. He's one or two at the free throw line. He has 3 points tonight. He's a got it. Rimmed that one go. And right now is the time when we need those points, boy. Well, we need them.
We had a drought there in the first half, Bill, that got us in a 13-point hole. Fortunately, Philippe Phillips, Wayne Poop out, gets hot. Some 3-point range gets back to his contention. We don't need that here in the second half.
Two of four combines a Ziggy Benton. Neil Jones takes it down, gets it. Rico Beasley working left corner. Rico looking down low, turns, picks up the dribble, needs some help, getting in, looking for help, gets it to Jones, he traveled with the ball, took a step to get the pass off, he had good key on him, and he walked with a 44-38, 6-point lead, 17:58 to play in the basketball game. It's Carlos Knox, right across the timeline, Knox works left side, picks it back out to Philippe Phillips, Phillips bounce pass feed to Sidney Pitton up on a high post, Pitton turns, hands to Knox, Knox, gonna put it up a three, up in the roll, that won't go. Rebounded Beasley, comes out with it, gives it to Neil Jones, and Jones will take it on the attack. Driving, penetrates, gets inside, pumps up a little six-footer, and they're going to let him get that close.
He did a good job of pulling up there before the defensive Ryan Bird got there. Short jumper in the lane.
That's 6 points now, left side, Carlos Knox, left wing. As they kind of go through there, they almost tripped up DeMarco, back outside to Carlos Knox, looks back out front. Gives it outside to Philippe Phillips, DeMarco puts up a three-pointer, won't go. Rebounded, picked up
here by Rico Beasley on the rebound for Tennessee State. Over to Neil Jones, and Neil will take it on your back. OVC game, playing Tennessee State. They're about, what, number two, I guess, in the OVC this year.
They've won eight of their last ten, Bill, and both of those two losses were the league-leading Murray State.
With the ball, Neil Jones, 15 foot right there, got it. Neil just coming him up. They let him go in there, and he's delivering from 68 feet in front of the basket. With the ball, it's Carlos Knox. He'll bring it out the timeline. Knox gives it to Felipe Phillips, and Phillips out front. Right side to Marco Wright, back over to Phillips. Phillips right side to Bird. Bird's holding on the right wing. Edges down a little bit, looking inside, and Knox puts it up again. Good move there. Great shot by Carlos Knox, and a good feed by Ryan Bird. 48-40 bases. Trailed by eight. Get the ball, it's Neil Jones, and Jones will take it on the attack. Jones working the left side. Jones looking in to Carlos Rogers down low. Carlos puts up a shot, won't go. Left red, and Luck goes off the fingertips of Carlos Knox. And Rogers, he was having a battle with Rogers. 6'11", and 6 foot, I believe, not 6 foot, I don't think. I think he's more like 5 feet.
You're right. Got a pound that way, though.
But he plays like a 6 footer, and I guess that's what counts. Pass out to Neil Jones, a Tennessee State. Adios, got low. Get it in there to Damon Page. Miss, gets up and tipped in, call his luck. When you're 6'11", you can do that.
They go long arms, go up and over. You can even beat
them. 50-40, 10-point lead in the second half of play. Pacers trailing by 10, driving left side. Phillips. Felipe pulls up, back outside to Carlos Knox, head of deep back to Felipe out front. Looking down low to Carlos Knox, baseline left corner, rolls it back on the left wing, lifts the ball quick, gets it over Marco right on the wing. They're going out after him, driving, but DeMarco looking. Down low to Carlos Knox, right side. Back out to Felipe, Phillips puts up a three out there. Good by Felipe.
Gotta pick up the slack, the foul on the bench.
Long one down to Carlos Rogers, puts it up, puts it in, the foul, foul on Ryan Curry. Oh, that's, how about that for transition?
That's a 6'11 player running the floor, too.
And he got back in the hurry. Carlos Rogers going on the free throw line, shooting 65%. DeMarco Wright steps down. Jim Locum goes in for UTM. We need some threes out of Jim.
Pacers' best bet so far tonight, Bill, is to put Carlos Rogers at the charity stripe. He certainly struggled there at 65%. He's on the season, not having a 5 or 10.
That's correct. That one's up and good. He hits that one, got the three-point play, the old-fashioned way, 53-43, 10-point lead now by Tennessee State. Collins knocked outside with it. Out there with the key looking, Jim Locum trying to post up. He got slammed out of there, kicks it back to Felipe Phillips up front. He's going to guard him pretty close now because he's a three-point shooter. And Felipe is out front. Jim Horton backs off and he plays with the key on him. Jim Locum puts it up in the corner. Off the rim won't go. Bradley Clark Jones picks up the rebound. And Jones shovels it down the floor and they heard it. Jim Horton. Jim Horton down low to Rogers. Rogers gets it under low. He walks the ball. And he got the pass off and he shot the second in the Damon Page and missed. And he's looking at the ball now. He's taking across the timeline. There's Felipe Phillips. Puts up a three up and off the rim. Won't go. And it slapped around. It slapped out of bounds. And somebody hits the desk over there and the ball went out of bounds. And the Damon Page, he got the jab out. But Tennessee State, Rico Beasley comes in. Page goes out. 53-43, 10-point lead by Tennessee State. Carlos Knox gets the inbound pass. Carlos bounce back into Locum. He's open out there. Going to shoot a three. And all the rim on that. He's squared up. Wasn't going. Tied up on the rebound. Possession error goes to UTM. Usually pretty good when you get his feet set. Well, he's had a couple opportunities in the last minute. Did get his feet set on both of them just off on both 3-point attempts. He did get his feet set, but he had his shoulder kind of angling when he went to the square. And I think that's when the ball hit the front of that rim. Outside there, the key, right side to the Felipe Phillips down low to Bird, outside to Benton. Benton over to Carlos Knox, he was short underneath. He drills the ball down the floor and intercepted by Benton. Now to Carlos Rogers, he threw a baseball pass. Down low to Benton. Benton takes his man, and he had him on back, and Carlos Rogers bellied up to Benton and fouled him. Rogers has picked up his first foul tonight. All that fighting inside, he's only has one foul. What do you think?
Well, that's what a good pump play for this one. Yeah. You know, he didn't use the pump play perfectly that time. Carlos Rogers bid for it and picked up the foul.
Boy, Biggie Benton is on the line. He's 2 of 4 free the line tonight. This one's up and good. Biggie gets another. 3 of 5 at free the line. It's 53-44. Sidney with a free throw. Senior 6'6", 210 from Higgins, Jeremy, Missouri. Got it and got it. 53, 3:45, 8.8. Neil Jones brings it in. Neil drives left side, pumps it up off the good. They let Neil drive in there. Neil's delivering. He has 10 points picked up from his hand. Malik Phillips with the ball, picks up the dribble, gets it back to Knox. Knox out front. Knox over to bad pass to Locum. Locum on the right wing. Back over to Malik. And Malik took the three, missed. Rebound to Carlos Rogers, gives it back to Neil Jones, and Jones will take it down. Boy, one of our prolific free throw shooters is sitting on the bench, loaded with four fouls, and that's the Wayne rebound. Jones with it outside. Jones looking in. Jones back over to Horton. Horton with a drive. Pulls up, lays it up on the right side, and got it. Tim Horton took it to the hoop. He has 6 points. Now takes it down out there to D. Dubuque, using right side. Here's the late Phillips. Back out front to Sidney Bick. Taking the outside. Holding, looking just to Jim Locum. Rolls up high, takes it. Jim backing up. Looking to the up, right side, Philippe Phillips. He's going to take him to three. Good by Philippe. Got to have it. That's 5-3 for him tonight.
An important hurt here in front of us, Bill.
Right in front as they were cutting down the floor. Yeah, Russell. There's 57-48, 9-point lead. 13-11 to play.
Maybe hold his side.
Well, an elbow there, or he has to go out if the coach has come on the floor. He has to go out. There may be some time. No, they're not taking time. I don't know. They might. Here comes Gurnell in for him. Roy Gurnell is coming in. So they get Tim Horton down the bench. Did you see what happened?
I did not see what happened. I saw them all running down the floor after Philippe Phillips' fifth three-pointer.
Neil Jones will take it on the attack. Neil moves it down. Left to right side. Neil. Janelle got a screen for him outside to Rico Beasley out there to see. Rico looks him in against the Rogers. Rogers down low, back out front to Janelle. He walked. He took a step. Janelle traveled with a basketball turnover. That time, good defense. Got a
foul losing the CCM step. And this is a critical time. They brought two foul back with the four fouls. 13 minutes to go in this basketball game. And UCM down only nine.
And at the time, they know they've got to get a run here somewhere right along about now. Ball up on the high post to Sidney Bick. Then with it outside, gives it to Lee Phillips. Now they see that Robinson rolls it up and won't go. Tipped up and kicked in by Houston.
There's a pick and roll, and Houston gets the garbage.
57-50 Pacers. Trail by seven. Trying to get a run, trying to get back in this thing. With a basketball moving down Neil Jones. Jones working left on the left wing. Jones with it. Left side. Top short pass to Rico Beasley right wing. Beasley down low to Gurnell. Gurnell looking for help. Here's to Jones. Jones puts up a shot. Jones for center shot. Neil Jones is the man the hour for him. He has 12 points, 8 to pass. With it driving, Philippe Phillips. Put a little pop underneath. Got it, missed it. Badly far. Slapped it right on the back. And it's Badly far. Down the goal. Jim Walker kicks it out. Kicks it out to Duke. Duke's the rebound. Two foul at Tennessee. Puts up a three. Off of him. Won't go. Rebound is picked up here by Rico Beasley. Down to Neil Jones. And Jones driving. Kicks it right side, gives it to Beasley outside. Puts up a three, puts in a three. Boy, that's nice. That's 4-3 for him tonight. 52-50 score. Boy, did you see the hustle and the scramble on the deck a few moments ago?
Well, great hustle by Philippe. But then Jimmy Locum, he
threw the loose ball. He may have some blood coming out of his nose, too. I think that's what he had. In that scramble down there, he was on the deck. He was fighting for the ball. Just, you take these youngsters, you don't want to win this ball game.
Yeah, he did a great hustle.
We just got to witness what we just saw right in front of us right there. There's going to be some timeout on the floor. While we get this timeout, let's just take a break on the Facebook Sports Network. Back here at Trace Arena, and I tell you, the pom-pom jazz got all over the TV screen that time on WLJT TV.
It's a good piece in here, Bill. I know why you do
52. Bases down by 10. Neil Jones on the attack. Neil takes it down the right side drive. Baseline pulls up, kicks it back into Rogers. And Rogers is flat footed, slapped away. Dick picks it up. Dick coming in from the floor. He lost the ball. Davis stole the ball to the Jones. And Jones by himself lays it up in here. Front of a gun. Turn it in. Chris Fusen will tell his family and his folks in one day that he blocked an NBA player's shot at the University of Florida. He's done it. He did it. Carlos Rogers shot first. Fusen did it. A number one job, though. Carlos Knox on the right hand. Just to get Fusen down low to right. And in the street. Blocked away here by Carlos Rogers. He just delivered one right back. Now to Jones. Jones driving. Right side. Here comes Mason. Look at the lead. He drills up front of him. 22 feet away. 5-3 for him tonight. Went down low to Benson. He's going to have to shoot. And they pinned it on the board. And it's picked up here by Carlos Rogers. Rogers down the left side. I thought it was a 10-1. It hit. Shot taken in the corner, missed. Rebound is taken over here. Chris Houston is backing the ball. Here to PayPal, and he comes the other way. Poole on the attack here for Houston. Timeout's going to be taken. There's 10 minutes to play in the basketball game. 67-52. Bases down by 15. Let's just take a 60-second break on the Bases Sports Network. Time he didn't win the argument because that Leslie was holding Bird as abuse. I think it was all abuse. Locum is going to inbound the basketball. Locum and foul, and Malik Phillips and Bird and Ricky Benton in the ballgame for UPM. Rodgers going to sit down for a while. How about him out? Dick Johnson is in there on the post. Don't get away but 2 inches. Not quite as mobile as Carlos Rodgers, but a big fella, 250. Got bigger man than Carlos. Malik Phillips left side to Ryan Burge. Burge on the left wing. Back to Malik Phillips. Leslie pulls up. Got it through. Good by Malik. He has 6 threes tonight. 71-57. Paces down by 14. And Neil Jones on the right wing. Jones looking back outside. Gives to Tim Horton in the deep. Right side to Jones. Takes one. Then takes it back to Horton. Horton pumps it up 10 feet away. Horton pumps it in.
Horton got away with a walk just earlier in that possession.
Yeah, Ward went crazy over him.
He did.
Right side, two foul. He's got 72 with it. Being pressured there by Watson. He's got the ball in the yard. Two with it. Watson's reaching in, trying to get it. He pulls up. He's hit it. Good by two. Had his foot on the line. He has 14 points with him. 73-60. Bases down by 13. With 7-13 to play in the ballgame. Greg Watson's in law. He's looking right. Looks outside. Gets to Horton. Horton back out there. Foul down low. Holding. Burge. Burge has picked up his third. You know, I wasn't watching Horton speak tonight. Just about every time, he'll just about walk, take a step backwards, sideways to get geared up.
You're exactly right. And a couple of times he's been called for it, but more times than not, he has.
Well, the ref is going over to talk with the scorekeeper at the table. Need a mic over there to find out what's going on. Ball will be inbounded by Tim Horton. Horton out to Watkins, and Watkins outside. Watkins works down on the right wing, looks down low. Horton breaks out of there. Instead, gives it outside. Rico Beasley puts up a shot off the rim, won't go. Rebound here by Pooh Powell. He's running. Pooh is going to bring it across the timeline. Stop, shot, side, puts up a three off the rim, won't go. We better put Burge to that with a shot. Can't go!
Ryan Burge first through the night. Burge did something smart there, Bill, and he was awful quick with a stick back with a presence inside like Johnson, a 6'9", 250-pounder, and some of the other things he faced out. They got to be quick when you make that decision.
Well, the basketball is Watkins. He almost dropped the pivot foot, too. Watkins is now right side to Horton.
ball down around your waist.
You're right. Beasley got inside that three-point line. Got it. He had better stay outside that circle. He hits better out there. On the call is Knox. Knox driving baseline. Comes back with a shot. And he
rolled in.
Yes. As Carlos Knox got fouled going to the bucket.
Well, you can see Carlos Knox playing with so much confidence, Bill. He had a career high getting 15 pick in the Pacers win on Monday night, breaking a 10-game losing streak. And he's played awfully well here again tonight.
Carlos, Tim Horton got the foul. A chance for the three-point play shoot by Carlos Knox. He's 5 of 5 in the line. Has 16 points tonight. You know, he's the kind of guy who gets better with his playing time.
Cal Luther tells me he's probably the best shooter on the team.
He's got it, he got it.
That's a pretty high company there. Phillips move out.
Well, you know, sometimes the pure shooters, in when he gets the playing time like he's got, he's come on real strong. With it right side is Jones. Jones out front shoves it quickly to Rico Beasley. He's got the hot hand. They want him to shoot the three. Neil Jones back outside to Davis. Davis, there's an 18-footer taken near, but Jones missed. Rebound to Poupal. He brings it down. He comes across the timeline. Pacers get it down in a hurry, too. Jones gets back with him. Looks, works outside, gives it to Khalid Phillips. Going to take him a three. Up and out, won't go. Rebound it. They went off the city of his hands. Jones picks it up. Jones will bring it across the timeline. Down the right side, gives to Horton. Horton puts up a 3-point and won't go. Rebound of a Benton, and Benton running. He'll bring it across the timeline. Benton lobs right side. Pooh got him a three. Pooh from the right wing. 79-70 down within 9 right now with 4:24 to play the basketball game. And time is going to be taken. Timeout on the floor. 79-70. UTM trails the 9. Let's just take a 60 on the Pacers Sports Network.
One of the few. From New York City, New York.
Let's shoot it, fellas. Let's get the flow of things. He walks it down, trying to shoot it off a little bit here. As Neil Jones looking right side. Jones down low in the face of Rogers. Rogers puts it up, won't go. Gets up by Rogers, tipped in by Rogers, and the foul is called. As Carlos Rogers, once again, got fouled and a chance. Benji Benton picks it up, his third, going on the free throw line for the three-point play. The old-fashioned way will be Carlos Rogers.
UTM 12 of 31, 39% of the second half, 16 of 30 for Tennessee State, 53%. The Pacers 7 of 8 for the charity strike, 87%. 18 of 16 rebounding edge for Tennessee State.
Rogers' free throw was good. Carlos Knox will bring it down for the Pacers. Working right, backing out of there. Heavy traffic there. Khalid Phillips over to Poupal on the left wing. Back to Carlos Knox up high. Carlos with it out front in the corner of the boot. Horton with it in the corner. Horton inside to Carlos Rogers. Rogers on the follow-up shot, and he put it in, and he got decked.
Yeah, that's a big-time shot there by the future NBAer.
Calling away, and he did it. He kind of shoot it across the floor, and he needs an option for that, too. But that's it looks better if he sprawled on the floor, didn't he? He's a good ball player. We don't mean to belittle his efforts one iota. That foul is called. Number 32, Bird, got it. Bird just picked up 4 fouls, and he just picked up 3, so it's good. He got the 3-point play the old-fashioned way. 85-73, 12-point lead here by Tennessee State. 2 fouls gives it to Khalid Phillips. Khalid out front to Carlos Knox. There's a few baskets down low to Bird. Back out to Carlos Knox, driving, penetrating, getting inside. He's going to put it up there. It's going to miss. And they're going to battle Park. It's going to go in the corner, and they're still stumbling around Park. Left back in. Picks up the rebound. Beasley. Beasley gets to Jones. Jones is lost. Neil Jones, it takes 2:35 to play in the ballgame. 73-85, faces down by 12. Jones on the right wing. Jones looking inside. He calls Rogers out to Tim Horton. Get inside. 15 for the Horton. Up and out won't go. Rebound of a 50-pick. Big shows it quickly down to Carlos Knox. Knox lays it up and in for two.
That was a great catch by Carlos.
39 to play in the basketball game. This one's up and good by Neil Jones. He's one of two of the line, shooting 75% on the year. You know, Neil Jones has come off the bench at guard. He's a senior. He lost his starting role, and yeah, he's doing the job tonight. He hit that one.
Well, I think he's got a special second half.
Yeah, yeah. Cole's got a count with him, I guess, at that time. He said, you got to deliver, buddy. Well, he poop out down to Benton. Benton puts up a three, and it out will not go. The battle for the ball picked up here by Rico Beasley out front. Rico gives it to Neil Jones, and Jones will take it on the attack. Jones comes across the timeline. His father's not picking up from the crowd heading toward the exit because of the snow and ice and everything. I don't know how far anybody will go tonight. We're going to check the weather conditions out there after a while. As Jones with it outside, Carlos Knott working out front. Jones is trapped over the right side, runs it to Horton. Horton back out front, whips it down low there to Carlos Rogers, deep right corner, and he puts up a long three-pointer, missing. Bradley Farr picked up by the foot foul. He came out of nowhere. He's driving through, lays it up, and he's a foul by Carlos Rogers.
Well, if I'm using him, that's where I want Carlos Rogers shooting the basketball out there, about 23 feet from the goal. But if I'm Frankie Allen, I think I might have a word with him.
Frankie, I think, jumped up and he was whipped by as he's coming down the sidelines. I think he did have a word or two. Probably Carlos didn't hear him. He's coming down so fast.
Carlos didn't want to hear him.
No. The way Pooh Powell's one of two, shooting over 80%, it's three for line. He's on the line now. He hits that one. He's two or three. Big important time to hit him. As the pace is now back to within 11. You never say die, Miss Green. Not over to the fat lady things and all that good stuff. This is rough and good. Three or four of the lines away from that. 87-77. Jones lobs down the floor to Rogers. Rogers lays it up. But I think they should have called goals in there. It may have been a foul before that. Did you see Felice Phillips get up? That's the 6 footer you were talking about there. And he got up and slapped the ball off the square on the bucket. Benton got the foul. That basket didn't count. He was fouled before he got there. I tell you, Felice swatted that thing. We're going to say it's only bad with Art Cunningham, but he really, as you said, got up. Carlos Rogers is on the line. Got it. And the rim, that won't go. Benton grabs the rebound. Sidney Benton gets it down the floor to Pooh Powell, and they're bringing on the attack. Driving, right side, pulls up, looks for help, keeps it out that touch to Lee Phillips. He turns up a long, well, 25-footer!
Does he have some range, or does he have range?
Has spring in his legs, did he not? 89-80, Pacers down to 9, 34.8 seconds left to go. This timeout, less second 60 on the Pacers Sports Network.
Next time on Austin City Limits, Country Star John Anderson. Saturday night at 7 o'clock. On the airplanes of the Serengeti.
Back court, so they want to get caught in a hurry. I was just looking here. Who was that foul on? I called it Knott. Knott picked up his third foul. I was just looking after tonight. The Pacers go on the road. We'll be at Austin Peay Clarksville next Wednesday night. Take a week off, and we'll be at Moorhead on February the 19th, Saturday and Monday, Eastern Kentucky, in Richmond, Kentucky. So we got a on the road. We'll be back here with Southeast Missouri on February the 26th, and Murray State February 28th, and wind up on the road March 2nd at Evansville.
And UT Martin played well here in this building. Neil, they don't have a lot to show for it as far as the victory column. But once again tonight, a very athletic and gifted Tennessee State comes in here and has to play hard to beat the Pacers.
They do. I tell you what, we've been very competitive, I think, all year. I don't know of any team that could have blown us completely away, you know. We've been competitive with them, and I think this team is coming. He had to give it some time, a couple of more. Yeah, he missed both free throws. Neil Jones did. Pacers grabbed the ball. Pooh Powell comes down the floor. Pooh puts up a three. He was really contested there. Goes out of bounds. Trying to get the save was Ryan Bird. Got it back into Locum, but they said he was out of bounds when he got the save. So 25 seconds left to play the ball game. It's going to be Tennessee State basketball. What one official out front called something.
He said the ball was partially deflected. What it was he hit Powell on the wrist, and now Powell picked up a technical foul.
I don't know whether Powell picked it up or maybe Bob Ward picked it up. Who did pick it up?
Powell picked it up because it's just personal.
Well, we
got a T and he's got a they waiting to move by on his side out with 25.3 seconds left to play. Tell you what, there was a lot of hot discussions that the ball was tipped. Well, Pooh ended up with 22 points tonight, I tell you that. Jim Locum is back in. So shooting on the free throw line, we'll go Curtis Jenkins is in the ballgame shooting. That technical, got it.
Curtis Jenkins just checked into the ballgame to shoot this technical foul.
Shooting 80% free throw line. Maybe we'll check in, reckon. Got it, yeah. Sure, sure, the line had good form. Now he may check it. Now he's going to stay in.
Got to stay in to leave.
Somebody said, you the man. Beasley gives it back to Jones. Jones way out front. Jones goes all by his lonesome face with a 200 jam. That's his first basket this half. He has 11 points, though. Jim Locum with the ball. 93-80 score. Outside 25-footer again here by Philippe Smith. Rebounded Rogers. Rogers takes it down, works right side. He's going to put a three from way out there, missing. And Bird grabs the rebound, the ball game is up. 93.
I'm talking to Karen. My next guest nickname is Penny, but after signing a deal for approximately $65 million, we should change it to Dollar Bill. Get Penny, brother. Hey, check out this shit. Where did the nickname Penny come from?
I hate to say it, but this nickname that my grandmother gave me when I was very young, and the reason why she said she gave it to me is that I was pretty as a penny. So I've never liked to say that, though.
I mean, that's kind of a goofy nickname. That's grandma. That's grandma, really, you know. Yes. Let's see. Playing in the NBA is so different than college. Who's the toughest man you've had to face?
Without a doubt, I think Joe Dumont.
Really?
We're at Detroit. Early in the season, and I was trying to guard him, and I got 3 fouls in a row. He didn't still do much. I had to sit and miss the whole first half, and I was over there thinking, man, this guy's tough.
Yeah. What is it about him? What did he keep throwing at you?
I don't know. He kept driving the ball on me. I never could stop him. I mean, that's the only person in the NBA right now that who I've had the most problems with.
Yeah. Magic said to me one time, he said, when I watch him play, I feel like I'm looking in the mirror. What do you think he means by that?
I don't know. I guess the past would go to, you know, I was with him this summer, and he told me the same thing. He's like, man, you remind me of myself so much. You know, the height, I'm going to run the point guard position, like the more showtime style of play.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You're with Shaquille. Somebody said he might have had a little bit to do with you actually being there. You know, like,
I think so. We came here for the movie Blue Chips, and we were on Paramount Studios, and we played basketball together every day, and he started liking the style of play that we were playing together, you know, reminding each other of Kareem and Magic type deal. And he said, I might want to ask Orlando to take another look at you because I had already been down once to, in a tryout to work out for the team, and it didn't work out that well. So he said, I'll ask you, have you back down again. And that's what happened, and I think he's a good part in that.
Let me ask a question. This may have an obvious answer. But somebody who goes to Orlando and the tryout doesn't work good, then he goes back and they give him $65 million. What happened that first time for... Who was smoking crack that second time? It's like, that's a big difference.
It is. Like, it was so intimidating. I mean, I went in there the first time, and, like, the head coach left, the general manager left, and nobody watched me work out. So I told Steele what happened, because we were doing the movie while the first time I went down there. I said, man, nobody watched me. He was like, okay, I can handle that. You know, Castillo, nobody's going to really tell him no fast. So he called and got me down there again. So it's good for me.
Yeah. You've mentioned this movie a couple of times. Did you have to take action yet?
No, I didn't. I think the thing that happened was Kevin Benton, he's in the movie also. When I first came down, he picked me up from the airport. He said, I have somebody who wants to work with you with the script. It was Larry G, the guy that played Navar.
Yeah.
And Revenge of the Nerd. He helped me out that night, and he stayed on the script for about 2 hours, going back and forth. And he played the Keith Bell, who was Nick Nolte, and I played Butch, played my own character, and it worked out.
Yeah. Hey, Marlon, we got another segment? Let's take a commercial, and then give me a clip from Blue Chips. I'll be back with Anthony Hardaway. Anthony Hardaway, who has a movie called Blue Chips that opens nationwide February 18th. Shaquille O'Neal is also in the movie. Nice, nice film. Let's show them a clip.
Coach, I need to talk to you. Good. Go ahead. Coach, I'm homesick. Homesick? Homesick, huh? Well, let me tell you something, Bruce. Every year, a couple of guys come in here and tell me they're homesick. And everything is going to be fine once the season starts.
I don't belong here. I mean, I've never ran the motion offense. That's not my style. I need to be in a 1-4 offense where I can handle the ball and dish the other people. I mean, that's my style.
But let me tell you, no, I don't know if it's the right place. I just can't live it with my way.
Coach, I don't belong here. I guess what I'm really trying to say is, if I left school, would my mom lose her house job? One thing I like about you, when I look back into your background, there was a point where you were having some grade problems, and you got busy. It was real important to you. You brought your average up and everything.
I think the thing that happened to me in high school is I was very poor. You know, I was a high school star. I didn't have to do anything. I mean, my teachers, you know, they let me get away with murder. So I think he caught up with me, you know, going to college because I didn't pass those exams. And then once I got into college, it wasn't the fact that I could never do any work. I just didn't want to do it. You know, and I got caught up with girls and everything. And once my grandmother, you know, we had a serious talk when I was freshman in college. She said, this is where you have to do it because you can't rely on anybody else. And came out making a major dent just 3 semesters in a row.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Well, for kids out there to get wet. Also, there was a period in your life. What happened when you didn't stop in the foot?
Well, Memphis was pretty rough. And day after I had just got finished, you know, playing basketball, and this car kept passing by my home, and so I was already outside, and the car stopped, and the post office said, could we find a certain neighborhood, and we knew what was about to happen, so we just tried to get him away as soon as possible, so we could just try to run or get away or something, and they pulled guns out on us and said, hey, just get on the ground, and took all our valuables, and then they hopped back in the car, and then when they drove off, they started shooting back to where we were. I mean, I know I wasn't going to chase him, so I don't know why he started shooting, but the bullet ricocheted off the ground and hit me in the foot. And then on, you know, it went down here.
Mm. Does that foot ever give you any problems?
Not anymore. Once I got shot, they couldn't operate and take the bullet out immediately. They had to leave it in for like 6 months. So I had to walk around with a bullet in my foot. And people started making jokes about, could I go to the airport? Could I, you know, and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I guess that probably motivated to get to another neighborhood and succeed or something.
I saw the car passing by. I mean, I wasn't noticing it. It made me notice a lot more things nowadays. It's because if I'd have been aware of the clock, you know, it's passed like 6 or 7 times, and it probably wouldn't have happened. I probably would have went ahead and went into the house before anything happened. But it made me realize that I can't go out anymore, because I was going out all times tonight, going to different nightclubs, and I just, it taught me not to just even go out anymore, just be aware of things.
Well, continued success. We'll be watching you, and we're going to go check out the movie. Okay? Right, Grandma, we all said hello.
Anthony Hardaway!